Hi, I'm Intel Technology Evangelist Marcus Yam, and I have a question for you. Are you ready to explore a new dimension of performance? Today, we're talking about Raptor Lake. Now, I know that sounds like a Jurassic Park spinoff, but it's actually the 13th generation of the Intel Core desktop processor line and the successor to the 12th gen Intel Core, codenamed Alder Lake. Alder Lake laid a strong foundation for the future with the introduction of the Intel 7 process node and a reimagined chip design that combines two different core types, the high-speed performance cores, or P-cores, and clusters of compact efficient cores, or E-cores, for responsiveness even when tackling major workloads. With E-cores carrying the weight of the countless background and low-priority tasks, the P-cores can stay focused on cruising through the most demanding work, such as rendering 3D models or spitting out the highest frame rates in the latest games. Raptor Lake is picking up where Alder Lake left off to deliver more of a good thing, like higher clock speeds, more cache, and, how about even more E-cores? Our trainers at Intel have been hard at work wrangling down these Raptors, and the result is even more of a good thing. While Alder Lake chips topped out at 8 P-cores and 8 E-cores for a combined 16 cores and 24 threads, Raptor Lake for desktop stretches the die for additional clusters of E-cores, paving the way for a class-leading Intel Core i9-13900KS with 8 P-cores and 16 E-cores for a total of 24 cores and 32 threads. That, at 6 GHz peak turbo frequency, makes it the world's fastest desktop processor. It's not just the top-line SKUs that are getting loaded up with cores, either. In Raptor Lake desktop chips, you'll find Core i9, Core i7, and even Core i5 models packing in those E-cores. Recently released i3 models, however, will retain the same all-P-core configuration as our last generation of Alder Lake-based models at the bottom of the stack. With all these cores on hand, Raptor Lake enables substantial multitasking capabilities, with results of up to 41% faster benchmarks in multi-threaded tests. Thirteenth-gen Intel Core processors will continue to benefit from the Intel Thread Director, which intelligently assigns tasks to the right core at the right time with nanosecond precision. With more cores to go around, that means more tasks handled all at once. When multitasking isn't a priority, all the cores and available threads can work together for extreme multi-threading. If you're hitting your machine with a huge video editing task, you can throw all 32 threads of a Raptor Lake chip at the job and watch your system run as fast as, well, a Raptor through all that work. And with almost a year of training on Alder Lake, Intel Thread Director's AI instructional set is more robust than ever. This is thanks in part to a combination of improvements achieved through machine learning, as well as optimizations in newer versions of Windows 11 that allow for better relationships between competing tasks. The number of cores is only one factor in performance. The speed of those cores is another. Simply said, Raptor Lake is faster than Alder Lake, hitting increased turbo speeds of up to 6 GHz and delivering improved instructions per clock. Depending on configuration, the higher core counts and higher clock speeds are matched with increased L2 cache for the P cores and double the L2 cache in E cores, now with up to 4 MB allotted per quad-core cluster, with an overall increase in Intel Smart Cache on select Raptor Lake desktop chips, including the Core i5 line. These hardware improvements are all fed through a smarter prefetching algorithm. And the result? All of this combines to let Raptor Lake take the performance hybrid architecture introduced with Alder Lake to a whole new level. Unlocked K-series Raptor Lake chips also know when it's time to go fast. Thermal velocity boost allows them to ramp up speeds in demanding tasks when the system reports there's enough thermal headroom to do so. In other words, when demand goes up, performance goes up, even as high as 6 GHz under the right conditions. When demand goes back down, the system can dial it back to save on heat and energy use. Thermal velocity boost gives you the most performance possible whether operating on a single core, a few cores, or every core all at once. While thermal velocity boost can operate automatically to speed up Raptor Lake, you'll also find wide-ranging overclocking support to let you take clock speeds into your own hands. Intel Speed Optimizer and XMP let you overclock K-branded processors with a single click. Alternatively, the Intel Extreme Tuning Utility, or XTU, enables more granular overclocking, including per-core overclocking for those who want full control. A new user interface designed for the XTU will also make it easier to manage and monitor overclocking, power, and CPU health. Naturally, Raptor Lake carries all the major tech upgrades introduced in 12th Gen Alder Lake. Raptor Lake will continue to offer support for both the previous generation of DDR4 memory, but can also tap into the latest DDR5 memory with support for increased speeds of up to 5,600 megatransfers per second, up from the 4,800 megatransfers per second in the previous generation. Now, Raptor Lake doesn't pass up on I/O to make room for those cores either. Raptor Lake desktop chips will use a separate platform controller hub, or PCH, to interface with extra peripherals. Peripherals continue to benefit from an abundance of PCIe bandwidth. Raptor Lake for desktop will provide a PCIe 5.0 by 16 or 2 by 8 connections directly from the CPU, giving the latest graphics cards or storage drives double the per lane bandwidth of PCIe 4.0. Another PCIe 4.0 by 4 link coming from the CPU gets dedicated to ultra-fast storage. That's all topped off with I/O coming from a separate PCH on the motherboard that shares a DMI 4.0 link to the CPU with 8 lanes worth of PCIe 4.0 bandwidth. On peak-configured Z-based motherboards, the PCH can provide an extra 16 lanes of PCIe 4.0 and 12 lanes of PCIe 3.0. This can give a system a total of 48 PCIe lanes to work with. All those PCIe lanes are handy for internal peripherals, but the Thunderbolt controls also make sure you get plenty of support for external I/O with Thunderbolt 4, which provides 40 gigabits per second of bidirectional bandwidth. You'll be able to pair Raptor Lake chips with the latest 700 series of motherboards to make the most of the new processors and benefit from the extra PCIe 4.0 lanes and USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 ports. Raptor Lake continues to use the LGA 1700 socket. This means retained backwards compatibility with legacy 600 series motherboards, making Raptor Lake a drop-in upgrade for desktop computers currently using Alder Lake, which is great if you love the motherboard you've already got, but you want even more performance. All these capabilities come together to make 13th Gen Intel Core processors a powerhouse in desktop computers, whether you use them for work, for play, or for a bit of both. Thanks for watching, and welcome to Raptor Lake. Until next time, I'm Marcus Yam, your guide for everything Raptor Lake. Blue!